What I want to tell you is that Swachh Bharat, you all know about it, and how it is going to succeed and why. I'm not going to talk about millions of ideas. Many of them are there, sitting here around within us when we are meeting today, translating it to thousands of people in the market. So, as a country, we indeed have some of the greatest challenges. Urbanization and population density. Bangalore was around 50 lakhs at the turn of the century, and it is over 1 crore today. Water availability has been a persistent challenge across most cities, especially over the recent years. There have been serious water shortages both at farm levels and at city level. The other thing is about waste treatment capacity and some of the horrifying stories that we hear about lakes like Belandur and Vatur really symbolizes that, because almost 75% of our wastewater discharges go to the bodies, spiritual bodies, and downstream. We also have frequent disasters and flooding, or it could be earthquakes and those kind of things. Climate change actually catalyzes these and they accelerate, and that also is a big challenge. And surprisingly, our disease burden on account of infectious diseases, due to majority of these factors, water availability, crowding, etc., means that our disease burden still stands to be very high among countries which can be said as comparable. Yeah? And in fact, that's the reason. Our healthcare organizations like hospitals and communities, you might find them bursting to see, because rural places don't have the right kind of facilities, so they come in here, and urban crowded cities also go in at the same place. So we often see hospitals resembling agencies. So this is a very pathetic.
Start recording.
And then on the backdrop, we are talking about Swachh Bharat. So is Swachh Bharat going to succeed because the government is doing it? Is Swachh Bharat going to succeed because
there is a policy, there is a campaign? And what I'm going to tell you today is that while those may be enablers, Swachh Bharat is actually going to succeed because of the creativity, the innovation, and the youth power of this country. Yeah? If India is going to be transformed, it is not going to be transformed by five big transformational ideas. It is going to be transformed by thousands of innovations that are done in the context of a specific geographic location, cultural context, or community context. And that is what the diversity, inclusiveness, and creativity of our people is going to be underpinning the success of Swachh Bharat. So, power of youth. Now, you might have already heard about the demographic dividend. Yeah? Our country is going to be having the youth advantage for over a decade to come. Our colleges will produce about 2 million engineers every year, and similarly more than 3 to 4 million science graduates every year. Now what does that mean? I don't know whether you have heard of this acronym STEM. It is Science, Technology, Engineering and Mathematics. India is on the way to becoming a superpower on that. And that is one of the biggest enablers for something like Swachh Bharat to succeed. And I'm going to illustrate that by talking about four stories. And these stories are about
provided the household knows when it is going to come. But more often than not, what is likely to happen, they do not even know when. Yeah? And if they well mean, that the water supply is going to come day after tomorrow at 3 p.m. and they have gone out. And two things happen. You don't get that supply, so there is a distress related to water. And the other thing is that they might have left the tap open and the water simply goes in. What next job day is to work with water supply organizations, the municipalities, and link them with all consumers, millions of them, through mobile telephone. So what they do is, if the municipality tells next drop that the water supply in this ward is going to start at this day, this time, that information is shared with the subscriber, so that the subscriber is aware the water supply is going to come and they will be at home, they will take their supply. Yeah? Also, what happens is that in case water supply doesn't come at that scheduled hour, then the consumers can complain back and the municipality is therefore alerted about maintenance and repair issues that is going to be addressed. Because otherwise, municipalities don't need to spice up the ground, they don't even know when there is a breakage or new system coming. So, this service gave a lot of peace of mind to the citizens, but also for municipalities to know whether their water is reaching the right places or not. The next story is about Arunachal and Gurunanakam, who has transformed women's hygiene in rural India. Now, he was a school dropout, very poor
Indian.
He did lots of different odd jobs, grew up, got married, and found that when his wife was
having this morning at an
hygiene, he was very touched and moved by it, and he decided to do something about it. The thing is that in a country like India, this is a taboo subject, and his pursuing this agenda to
suffering with various diseases, fever, diarrhea, urinary tract infections, and they really felt that the toilet provided by the school was the key to this problem. They found that this toilet did not have any urinal port, and the children were made to kind of urinate on the floor, and that kind of spill on their trousers and shoes and chappals and feet, and with that they would come into the class and it would be a messy affair. Now, one of the kids had seen these 20 liter bottles from where they were drinking water somewhere, and they reimagined that bottle. Yeah? Is that if water is flowing like this, can it be converted into a urinal? So they took that bottle, cut it vertically, diagonally, and converted it into this urinal, and then used inexpensive plastic pipelines to convert a very dirty toilet into a toilet which can be as good as any other toilet, say in a five-star hotel, in terms of hygiene levels. Yeah? But cost was almost orders of magnitude lesser than that. Clean, healthy toilets done very ingeniously and creatively by school kids. The last one, again, we have a major challenge in rural India. Of course, it is also there in the cities, but rural India, with all its population increasing, the wastewater comes there, but there are no wastewater treatment plants. So Professor Abbasi and some of his young researchers at University of Pondicherry developed a technology called Chevron. Yeah? What they did is very creative. You can get dirty bags almost free. Yeah? And you can create, fill sand in that and create some kind of a structure. Now if you line it up with plastic, you will be able to create ponds. Yeah? In these ponds, they cultivated some plants that have the ability to detoxify polluted water, let's say water hazard. So what happens is that in plants, they percolate water as a thin sheet, and the roots of the plant contact the water, detoxify it, and make the water safe, free of pollutants, such that it can be used for irrigation. Such a plant would otherwise cost more than 25 lakhs at scale, that amount of sewage that is treated. And this was less than 25,000. Yeah? So these four stories really tell us the ingenuity, the creativity, application of science,
amount of sewage that is treated. And this was less than 25,000. Application of science, application of engineering skills to the problems of India, and thereby it will help to advance. Now, out there are innovators like us who sit and analyze the post market, yeah? And we give it various names. Yeah? Some people call it Jugaad innovation. Some people call it Indonesian, is another term that is happening, out of the box, cross engineering. But these are terms that can be used to describe, and somebody writes an article or a little about it. But I think the people who have done it have not really heard about these things. Yeah? They have done it with their passion to make a difference to the society, help India move forward, and that's the reason I think the youth power, the creativity that we have here is something that we take from heart and soul. And I would really use this platform to urge you that if you have ideas to contribute to making India a better country, in this country, do it. And if you have the ability to nurture projects in that and take them forward, because they don't get food, do that. Thank you.